Get official WCW stuff.
This stuff up here is cool.
It's hot. It's happening. It's official WCW stuff. Caps, tees, and more. Official WCW stuff.
That's so pretty.
You can order official World Championship Wrestling stuff from the WCW merchandise catalog. Get yours today. Call 404-885-7168 to get your free official WCW merchandise catalog.
On TV, the world-class wrestling Von Erich brothers seemed to have it all. But behind the fame and fortune, something dark was lurking in the shadows. Something that took these strapping young men out of the limelight forever. John Johnston continues his exclusive report on wrestling's doomed dynasty.
David Von Erich has beaten the world champion!
Professional wrestling debut. Chris Von Erich, tackle him here. Harry Von Erich is the new world heavyweight champion. No doubt about it.
Inside the ring, the Von Erichs seemed to be invincible. Young, strong, handsome, and the fans loved them. But what the fans didn't know is that outside the ring, the Atkinsons were wrestling with reality, and one by one, each would take a fall.
It just seemed that there was a controlling negative providence that said, okay, you've had the glory, now let's see if you can handle the pain.
The pain that dropped Fritz Von Erich to the mat with the death of his first son, Jackie, in 1959, came looking for a rematch in 1984. Four times in the next 10 years, Fritz's family would fight death, an opponent they could not beat. The first to die was his 25-year-old son, David, nicknamed the Yellow Rose of Texas. He was mysteriously found dead on the floor of a hotel room while wrestling in Tokyo. The official cause of death was an intestinal disorder.
I went to my knees, just like someone had knocked my knees out from under me. And I was in another world. I couldn't believe that my boy David is no longer here.
In 1984, when Dave died, part of me did die, you know, and I lost like part of my heart, I feel like.
It seemed like all of Dallas loved David Von Erich. The funeral procession stretched 5 miles across the Lone Star State. It was a hero send-off, complete with its own ballad.
Heaven needed a champion.
But critics who know the ropes inside the wrestling arena maintain David's death might not be so squeaky clean. Dave Meltzer, who publishes the Wrestling Observer, has gotten reports that another wrestler on the scene when David's body was found flushed drugs down the toilet.
You know, it was a marketing thing. He died a hero's death when, in fact, if the drug story is true, which most people seem to believe, you know, that's not a hero's death in most people's eyes.
Despite this controversy, the Von Erichs will always be heroes. Just 1 month after David's death, 43,000 screaming fans turned out at Texas Stadium as Kerry stepped back into the ring to wrestle for the world championship title in his dead brother's name.
So I guess you can imagine the weight that was on my shoulders at the time, because I had to take that world heavyweight title. My brother David died. That was his dream.
This event is for the world heavyweight title. Kerry's got it. Here's what else is ahead. Go! At this very moment.
At this very moment, the Von Erichs seemed to be back on top of the world. Although Kerry was wearing the championship belt, it was Mike who would step in to fill David's shoes and become the newest member of the Von Erich tag team.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome to Reunion Arena for his first professional wrestling bout, Mike Von Erich.
They told me to expect some pain. I had a big
But it would be obvious 3 years later that Mike felt he had not lived up to the Von Erich mystique. After a near-fatal bout with the rare disease toxic shock syndrome, Mike quit fighting for good. He crawled into a sleeping bag and took his own life with an overdose of Placidil near the family ranch. That was in April of 1987. Mike was just 23 years old.
The note from Mike was strictly to his mother. And it says something to the effect that, Mom, you've been great. I'll be waiting for you and with my brothers.
Chris was really close with Mike. And Chris was he idolized Mike, wanted to do everything Mike did.
Chris followed Mike's footsteps right into the grave. Chris was the baby of the family. His growth was stunted, and he was weakened by asthma as a child. And at 5'5", he was a heavyweight at heart, but a lightweight in the ring. On October 12, 1991, Chris put a 9mm pistol to his head and pulled the trigger. He was just 21 years old.
Chris never thought that he could measure up.
No, never thought that he could, and all he wanted to do was be a professional wrestler. And he was just not going to be there for him, and Chris really down deep inside knew it.
As much as Chris didn't have the God-given talents, Carrie was truly blessed. With a body like Adonis, the charisma of a rock star, and the staying power that would surpass any of his brothers. While Carrie Von Erich truly enjoyed the public lust, few knew about the private demons he harbored inside. Carrie Atkinson was wrestling with cocaine addiction and losing. His marriage with his wife, Chris, was also on the ropes, a combination of blows which put him in the same death grip that brought his brothers down. Just 3 months ago, Carrie put a bullet through his own heart and left his family grappling with pain once again. His death would reveal the biggest secret of all about the modern-day warrior.
But what no one knew up till now, it's never been revealed that Carrie, when he had that bad wreck back in early 1986, he lost his foot. He's been wrestling all these years with a prosthesis.
This was, Fritz, the day Carrie died this past February. 3 months later, he took us back to the spot on his ranch where he found Carrie's body.
But I was urgently trying to find that boy.
It had to be running through your mind, oh no, not again.
When I couldn't find him anywhere else, remember that this one glove laying here and that Jeep was right there, I just almost knew Carrie had done it.
When you found Carrie, what ran through your mind at that time?
My baby's gone. I was just in another world. I couldn't believe it. He was gone.
Is there ever a time when you feel all alone?
Feel all alone? Heck yeah. Heck yeah. If I had a lot of brothers dying, you feel alone. Sure, my dad feels alone. My mother feels alone.
When you look at Kevin now, today, do you look at him any differently?
Quite differently. The only son I have left. And naturally, I'm afraid of this, I'm going to have that boy.
In a moment, the Von Erichs talk about the shocking end to this family of fame.
Nothing could hurt us in the ring or outside. I mean, we really believe that.
And the last surviving son looks at his future as a wrestler and a father.
Is that something in the future for him, do you think?
Well, it could be if that's what he wants.
Later this week on A Current Affair, a family's home video camera catches their neighbor's campaign of terror.
As you can see, with over 60 models already open and prices ranging from $50,000 to $500,000, finding the perfect home at Summerlin won't be difficult. It will, however, take more than 30 seconds.
Tobin Infinity's introducing the 1994 Q45s and the all-new G20s, both with standard dual airbags, a free loan-a-car program, 24-hour roadside assistance, and more. Because the 94s are here, Tobin's making you the dealer on all our 93 Q45s and G20s. Buy or lease now at factory invoice to take advantage of this buying opportunity and save. Visit our showroom today and we'll show you why Infiniti is voted the best overall car line in the world. Only at Tobin Infiniti.
Get me a boat to take me there. Silver sands on a white hot beach. All of
On your screen, it's the KOUC 50-minute music clock. It guarantees that 98.5 KOUC will play 50 minutes of number one hit music every hour, all day long. 98.5 KOUC is the number one hit music station, playing the hottest music by today's favorite artists. So tune your radio to 98.5 KOUC for 50 minutes of number one hit music every hour, guaranteed. 98.5 KOUC, the number one hit music station.
A hard copy special report. Three spectacular news-making events, all caught on tape. First, the race to save a desperate man from plunging off a 200-foot tower. Then, the shop owners who surprise their would-be robbers with machetes. And the daring helicopter rescue that spun out of control. These and much more in an all-new, all-caught-on-tape special half-hour on the next hard copy.
7:30 tonight, following A Current Affair on Fox 5.
One haunting question still remains. How can a father and son go on after death has taken away five people they loved? John Johnston finds out why they still see a ray of hope through all the blackness of wrestling's doomed dynasty.
Right, a triple drop kick.
It's not like wrestling convinced us that we were invincible. It wasn't like that. It was more like nothing could hurt us in the ring or outside. I mean, we really believe that.
The veil of invincibility that seemed to protect the Von Erichs in the wrestling ring has been ripped away by reality.
Got a body killing 24 years ago. Thought it might make a hell of a keepsake.
The foundation of family Fritz Von Erich once cemented with the hands of his children in this lab has been replaced with headstones. Five of his six sons dead, and his wife of 42 years has left him.
I never blamed my wife, and she never blamed me. But now she blames me. She says now that I'm the responsible for the death of all my children.
You can't blame him. I didn't come from a dysfunctional family. You just can't blame. And then it's cruel too. It's cruel to say that to to a man that you're responsible for the deaths of your son. That's ridiculous.
Kevin Von Erich, the sole surviving son, is once again trying to pick up the pieces, raising a family with four children of his own.
This is heaven on earth, really. I mean, what more could I ask for? Can't let the loneliness get too big of a monster, but sure, it's there. My brothers are gone, and there's no way that we're going to wrestle tag teams or anything like that again, and so life goes on, so be it. Here we are.
I notice he's got tape on his wrists.
Oh, yeah.
Is that something in the future for him, do you think?
Well, it could be if that's what he wants.
Is there any sadness in it, though, that if you are the last one, the legend of the Von Erichs in wrestling is over?
Of course, I'm sad that my brothers are gone, yeah. I've been a big brother all my life, and now I'm not even a brother.
When you sit alone at night now, and you think about five of six of your children gone, you feel alone?
Yeah, I cry. I guess pretty regularly. It washes over you real often. Terrible gone.
We consider every day we live to be a blessing, and we're thankful that for every day we have together. It's a real close family. We do everything we can together, and there's nothing can ever come between the Von Erichs. We're too tight.
Well, the last remaining Von Erich, Kevin, is still an international star, but he only wrestles charity events here in the United States. We'll be back in a moment.
My daughter can spot a cute boy at 150 yards. It's finding a tomato that gives her trouble.
Whirlpool thinks anybody should be able to find anything they need in a refrigerator.
If I hear "Where's the ketchup?" one more time, I'll scream.
Don't scream. This Whirlpool refrigerator has see-through bins, shelves that slide, and upfront lighting.
I like to see my kids fend for themselves.
Whirlpool. How to make a home run.
Here it is, the best secret roll-on ever. Now the active ingredient has a higher concentration of what keeps you drier. Secret's still pH balanced. It just works harder. Hangs in there, like you. Strong enough for a man. Now keeps a woman even drier.
How much pressure can you put on the tip of a nail before it breaks?
Skin Science Update.
At Vaseline Intensive Care Research, they've developed a hand and nail formula that makes nails 30% stronger.
From intensive research comes intensive care.
Summer's coming and the Las Vegas Athletic Clubs have the very best variety, plus the number one aerobics program anywhere. So get started now for only $5.
Work it. Work your body.
Feel it move to the groove.
This $5 offer ends Saturday, so call or stop by for a free guest tour.
Everybody,
work your body.
Work your body.
Come on, work it.
Hi, I'm Steve Linehan. Because Fairway is Nevada's largest volume Chevrolet dealer, we've helped hundreds of people with credit problems obtain loans through Fairway's Second Chance Finance program. Call me at 641-1400, and I'll help you get a loan as quickly as possible. Just ask our customers.
Steve got me a second chance loan in only 3 hours, and I was turned down elsewhere.
Second Chance Finance, only at Fairway Chevrolet Geo, Nevada's number one volume Chevrolet dealer.
The bigger the dealer, the faster the loan.
Tomorrow on A Current Affair, a family's fight to put their former son-in-law behind bars.
Jim and Bonnie Creighton's beautiful young daughter was gunned down by her crazed husband.
We've lost our daughter.
And now they fear he may get away with murder.
There is no justice in our court system.
He could be the last man in his state to walk free by pleading insanity.
The system needs to be torn apart. How can judges do these kind of things?
The Creightons think that's the law gone mad. Their gripping story on the next A Current Affair.
That story and much more Tuesday. And that's all for tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Maureen O'Boyle. Hope to see you back here tomorrow for the next A Current Affair. Good night.
You wore the family name with pride. Boldly you went forward. Did the things a lesser man might not have ever done.
Star Trek, The Next Generation, tonight at 10. Her Joppy is next on Fox 5.
Now you're gone. With the Lone Star State emblazoned on your battle togs, proclaiming you a native son with strength and love and pride. You're the morning star that shined for one brief moment in eternity. And all too soon, God called you to his side. Heaven needed a champion. That's why he took you. Heaven needed a champion. But God knows we need you too.